In part 8 of the PreTrig review, we go over how to determine if functions are even or odd and if they have any symmetries. The test is a really simple one to do. You plug in negative x to the function and simplify it. If f of negative x is equal to f of x, then we say f is even and it will have symmetry with respect to the y-axis. If f of negative x is equal to negative f of x, then we say f is odd and will have symmetry with respect to the origin. So let's give our example problems a try. And we've got example A here, f of x is equal to 5 minus x squared. So we do the test, f of negative x is equal to 5 minus negative x quantity squared. So that's 5 minus, now negative x quantity squared is equal to x squared. So we can see very easily this is exactly the same as our original f of x. So therefore, f is even and will have symmetry with respect to the y-axis. In example B, we have f of x is equal to 6x over x squared plus 4. So then f of negative x is equal to 6 times negative x divided by negative x squared plus 4. When we simplify this, we get negative 6x over x squared plus 4. And we can see that's exactly the opposite of the original equation. So this is equal to the opposite of f of x. So therefore, we say that f is odd and it will have symmetry with respect to the origin. Now, if we compare these two to the tests, example A, remember we did f of negative x and it worked out to be f of x, so that's why we said it was even. In example B, f of negative x worked out to be the opposite of f of x, that's why f was odd. Now if we look at example C, and we do f of negative x, we get the square root of negative x, and there's no simplification that can be done here. You want to be very careful that you don't accidentally pull out the negative sign from under the radical. It can't come out front. So since the square root of negative x is neither f of x nor negative f of x, we have to say that f is neither.